guys, so today we are going to be creating project 3, which is going to be a remix. Today we're going to be working with the song Lights by Ellie Goulding, and I just wanted to start from the very beginning. So before you do anything, you need to double check that you are in edu.bandlab.com and not just bandlab.com. Once you're there, you are going to click on in the upper right hand corner where it says log in. You do not want to click at the bottom where it says start as student. You should have already created your account using the link provided in Google Classroom. So once I click log in, I am going to click down below where it says log in with Google. And I'm going to select my school email account, because if I don't, then it won't be correctly identified within BandLab. So once I'm in there, I'm going to click my grade. I'm going to be an eighth grade student today. So you click on your class and you are going to click on Project 3 Remix where it says Start Assignment. One thing that you're going to notice that's different than before is that for Project 3, we already have a track in here. I can tell because I can see a sound wave that looks exactly like the sound wave should have looked like for Project 2. So I'm going to click Start Assignment, and then I'm going to click Teacher's Assignment. So once that's loaded, I'm going to notice that I have a vocal track, and that it goes all the way until about bar 6970. It was a little bit past 69. You're also going to notice that I've already gone in and chunked this loop into different sections. So I have the verse here, I have the pre-chorus, the chorus, I have verse 2 right here. I have the pre-chorus and one more chorus at the end. So knowing that, I need to have different energy levels for each of those sections. I've created a second energy level chart for you that goes over all of that. So in any verse, you're only really going to have 1 to 2 loops. One of the loops is going to be the vocal track, and you're going to add an additional loop to that. Then when we get to the pre-chorus, you're going to turn up the intensity just a little bit, and you will have 3 loops during any pre-chorus. Then during the chorus, you can have all 4 to 5 loops. Now remember, one of these loops is already in for you, so you're not adding quite as much as you had to in Project 2. I'm going to go back over to my vocal track. The first thing you're really going to need to do is to decide what direction, what vibe you want your sound to go in. So I'm going to listen to a couple options. My first one is New Orleans Bounce. I'm also going to listen to, I'm not going to pick rave because Ellie Goulding does do, there, it usually has a pretty heavy rave vibe to it already, but I'm going to listen to Witch House. And I'm going to listen to Grime Volume 2. Now, I think I'm going to go with my first choice, New Orleans Bounce. And the great thing about BandLab is now that my tempo is set and my key is set and both are correct, I don't have to worry about whether or not my loops are in the correct key. I can simply drag them in and they will adjust to what they need to be. So I'm going to click on New Orleans Bounce, and I know based on my chart that I need to start with a pretty low energy level for this verse. So in my mind, I think I just want like a low kick drum sound, and that's what I'm searching for. So I'm going to go back over here. And, you know, if there is something that there's a couple things that say beats, but I'm really looking for something that says kick, because I know kick drums are that low drum. And I can see that over here I have Nola Bounce Kick, and I'm going to listen to just a couple of these. So like maybe one. And that's just a little too inconsistent for me. I want like a really steady beat. I want to start with something very strong. So maybe I'll listen to four. I like that a little bit better, but I just want something a little more even. Let me listen to Nola Bounce Kick 7. And this is exactly what I'm looking for, like a nice full kick sound that's going to bring my song in but keep the energy level low. So I'm going to place that here, and then I'm just going to take a peek at my chart again. I really feel like this could sustain through the pre-chorus. It could be my one loop here that goes all the way through the pre-chorus, and then I want to kick up the intensity at the chorus. So I'm going to take my Nola Bounce Kick, and I'm going to drag it. I'm going to get rid of my loop pack. It's in the way. I'm going to drag it right to where the chorus begins, and then I'm going to stop. Now, just with every single part of this electronic audio engineering process, we always want to stop and listen and make sure that we like what we've created before we move on. So I'm just going to take a quick listen into verse one to see if I like how that sounds.
The queen has been overthrown.
So I like that a lot. I think that has that drive with a low enough energy level that I think that alone could sustain my first verse. I'm going to go to my pre-chorus now. At my pre-chorus, I should have 1, 2, 3 loops. So that means that I need to add in another loop at the pre-chorus. Because I have a low kick drum, I think it would be really appropriate to add in a hi-hat at this time. Let me go back over to my project. And I'm going to open this loop pack again at the bottom by clicking the loops. And I want to find something that says hi-hat. Let's see. Right here, I have Nola Bounce Hi-Hat. Just a pro tip here, all of the loops within a designated loop pack are going to be in alphabetical order. So if you're having trouble finding something and you know what it's called, that will help you to navigate. So let's see, I want a hi-hat. Let me listen to a couple of them. I think that's way too busy in the second half of that. I don't want to get too crazy quite yet. A little bit better, but again, less is more. What about four? Still a little bit, but I think I'm going to go with four. Again, I'm popping it in right at the pre-chorus, and I can already tell it's not aligned correctly. So let's talk a little bit about how to fix those alignment issues I saw all over Project 2. You're going to, first of all, close your loop pack so that you can see what you're doing. Go to the upper right-hand corner and zoom way in. So I'm right at 13 right now, and I'm just going to align my playhead, make sure it's really clicked into 13. I'm going to click on my loop pack, and I'm just going to drag it over until it's correctly aligned at the beginning. It should click in. I don't know if you saw that, but it just kind of like magnets to where it's supposed to be. And I'm zoomed in really far. Right here is bar marker 13, and here's 13.2. I'm gonna zoom back out. I'm just a little too close for comfort now. I'm going to stretch this through the end of the pre-chorus, and now I'm going to listen to that transition from my verse one to my first pre-chorus that happens.
But the queen has been overthrown, and I'm not sleeping now. The dark is too hard to beat, and I'm not keeping now the strength I need to push me.
So that sounds good. It's busy, but because my first track wasn't that busy, it doesn't affect it too heavily. Now I'm arriving at my first chorus. Let's take a look at our chart again, and I can see that for my chorus, I really should be kicking up the energy. So I want to change my drum track to a more busy drum track, and I want to add in a third track there. I think I might keep the hi-hat the same. So I'm going to go back over to my project. I said I want to keep my hi-hat the same, so I'm going to stretch that hi-hat. And remember, you have to click the upper right corner or it won't work. And I'm going to end that hi-hat at the end of the chorus. And I'm going to find a new drum track. So let's go down to loops. I'm still in my loop pack. And I think I'm going to opt for something called beats instead of kick. So let's see, what do I have here?
You show the-
I think I actually like that. It sounds a little slow. Don't be worried about any of that. I know it says it's 100 beats per minute in the corner, and this says 120. It will adjust, so there's no concerns with that. All right, I'm going to stretch this through the end of my chorus. Let me get rid of my loop pack that's in the way again. Clicking in the upper right-hand corner to stretch. And I'm just going to back up a little bit and listen to this transition.
Now, the strength I need to push me. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. Only shine it when I'm alone. And so I tell myself that I'll be strong, dreaming when they're gone, 'cause they're-
So I think that that's fine, but I don't think that it's enough. I'm going to need to add at least one more track. So I'm going to open up my loop pack, and I need more music, like melody in the background. So let me look for something that would be a melody. I see synth. Synths are going to be a good option. And I see voice tracks. So let me listen to the voice tracks real quick. Yeah, I don't know if that's what I'm going for. I think these are all going to be similar. I'm going to listen over at 5 just to see. Yeah. It's going to be like people yelling random things. So I don't know if that's what I want. I'm going to listen to these synths. Here's synth number one. I like that, but I kind of want busier. This is the chorus of my song after all, so I want the energy to be at its highest. I like that a lot. Energy. And I just don't love that one. So I'm going to go with Nola Bounce Synth 2. I'm going to drag that right at where my chorus starts. See how that's not properly aligned? I'm going to zoom in again. Slide over to where I am working in my piece. I zoomed in a little too far. All right. And I need it lined up with 21. That's where my chorus starts. So I'm going to just grab that and drag it over. Make sure it's locked in right at 21. All right. So now I'm going to go back to the beginning and listen to my entire composition through the end of the first chorus to see if that energy is building in an appropriate way.
I had a way there.
lights that stop me turn to stone. Only shine it when I'm alone. And so I tell myself that I'll be strong. And dreaming when they're gone. Cause they're calling, calling, calling me home. Calling, calling, calling home. You show the lights that stop me turn to stone.
So that is exactly what I was looking for. I build up energy very nicely. We reach a nice high point, a nice groove in the chorus. That is exactly what you are looking for. Now I'm in verse 2. When I look at my energy chart, I can see that for all of my verses, I want to have just two loops, no more. So I'm going to actually drop right back down to that nice heavy kick that I had before. I'm going to go over, see this Nola bounce kick. I'm going to two finger click and click copy. If you're not on a Mac, you can right mouse click. Then I'm going to go place my bar marker where I want it. And I'm going to two finger click at the end and I'm going to click paste. Excellent. So now it's in. And I see that it goes a little bit beyond where my chorus starts. So I'm just going to back it up a little bit. I think that that's going to be very worthwhile. Now I need to move in to my pre-chorus the second time it happens, and I need those three loops. And I'm going to build it up the exact same way. I think that it was extremely effective. So at my pre-chorus last time, I brought in my Nola bounce hi-hat. It goes all the way through, so I'm just going to extend it out to the end of the chorus. Oh, I'm lying. So I'm just going to go back. And I'm going to click on it, two finger click and click copy. And I don't want to bring it in until the pre-chorus. So I'm going to click over at pre-chorus. Sorry that I misspoke. I'm going to two finger click or right mouse click, whatever you have, and click paste. So now I have this extending. And since it goes through the chorus, this can go until the end of my song. 69 is actually where the end of my song is, even though those vocals spill over a little tiny bit. So I'm just going to have it end really firmly right there. All right. So now I have 1, 2, 3 tracks at my pre-chorus, and I need to move into my chorus. My chorus had 4 tracks before, and with my energy guide, my chorus should have either 4 or 5 tracks. That's fine. And I'm just going to evaluate what I did before. I had chorus, Nola bounce beat, 1, and I still had my hi-hat going, and I had my bounce synth. So I'm going to take my drums, my Nola bounce beat 1, two finger click, click copy. I'm going to make sure my bar marker is at 53, and I'm going to paste it right in. And then, last but not least, I need to move over my synth the same way. Two finger click or right mouse click, click copy. And then put my playhead over where I would like it at the chorus, which is bar 53, and paste. And then everything ends nicely at the same time. So as I'm going through, I did it last time, but I'll do it again. I'm going to play through my whole piece, and I'm just going to mess with the volume, decibel levels, the EQ over here, to make sure that if something's too loud, I'm bringing it down a little bit, and that I'm bringing out the parts that I want to hear the most.
Calling, 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 calling home. You show the lights that's scan and hope they're still breathing. And I think back to when my brother and my sister slept in an unknown place. The only time I feel safe. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. Only shine it when I'm alone. And so I tell myself that I'll be strong. Dreaming when they're gone, 'cause they're calling, calling, calling me home. Calling, calling, calling home. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. Only shine it when I'm
excellent. So I'm going to be very transparent that when you're messing with the EQ over here, a lot of that is optional. It's just so that you can make it the best song that you want to. And if you're finding that it's hard to tell the difference between two sounds, you can use this little pan knob. You can click on it and drag up to move it to the right side, the right headphone, or you can click it and drag down to move it to the left side. So I just did a little bit of that with my track with this hi-hat and this bounce synth to, you know, like balance them out a little bit. The hi-hat was too loud, I brought it down. Couldn't hear the synth, I brought it up and put it on the side. So that's it. Once you're finished with your entire project and you're happy with what you have, you are going to click that beautiful submit button in the upper right-hand corner. You can choose to leave me a little love note if you want or not, doesn't really matter. If you want to explain something about your project, this is a great opportunity right here, where you can even include emoji. And you're going to click submit one more time to make sure that your project is really submitted. So I'm not going to click submit right now, but that is it. You're going to need to make sure that you've watched this entire Ed Puzzle to get credit. And my special announcement to you is that you are exempt from attending the Zoom meeting this week because I am providing the lesson in this format instead. If you have any questions, I'm going to leave that Tuesday morning time open for appointments. So please, please, please just email me if you need additional one-on-one help, and that is totally fine. All right, till next time. See you later. Stay safe.